We return to more Mega Man Maverick Hunter X as we prepare to take down Armored Armadillo. Really? Armadillo?
Armored Armadillo!
Oh, well, if he puts that voice on, I'll see him. This is another one of my favorite songs in this game. Give Knife. This is also one of my favorite levels because it goes so fast. There's so much going on. And it just feels really nice. I like the feel of this level a lot. We're going to use fire. Fire! Use fire against this thing, and within a second it's dead. But there's an E-tank back here, so... Sweet. A nice touch that was added to this game, I don't think it was in the original, is if you don't have a weapon equipped, it automatically has the weapon equalizer. So if you're not equipped with a weapon, it'll automatically pick up weapon energy and put it into whatever you have the lowest of. I personally thought that was kind of a nice touch. This is a really good level for filling up your E-tanks, too, if you're ever really low. Come on. You jerk. I think I thanked you. And we're gonna go for another ride. Ready with the fire. Okay. Be ready with the fire wave when you go down here. You want to quickly destroy this enemy as quickly as you can. Because otherwise you can't get the heart capsule that's located up here. So you'll destroy the ground. Or the bearing, so you can't get up there. Ha. Coming through. If the game stops slowing down. You want to try getting rid of these guys, because unlike in the original Mega Man X, these guys actually do get in your way a lot, and can be the result of your death. Awesome. And that's the end of the level. It's a really short level, but I really like it, because it has a nice, high-paced feel to it. Armadillo!
I am under strict orders to protect this mine.
You don't need to take orders from someone like Sigma. He's insane. Open your eyes, Armored Armadillo.
Whether he's insane or not, it's not my place to judge him. I must obey.
Sounds like you've gone Maverick.
I'm taking you out.
Enough talk. I'm ready to obey my orders.
Go ahead.
Enough talk.
Armored Armadillo really isn't incredibly hard once you know what you're supposed to do. He starts off really slow, but the lower his health gets, the faster he becomes, which can kind of become annoying. At first, he has this slow little bouncing around. He has a second kind of roll attack, which he'll do if he starts moving immediately after he starts rolling. It means that he's going to be doing this one where he just starts bouncing up and down. But if he doesn't move right away, he's going to do a room roll. This one here, where he just spins around the room and progressively gets faster and faster. Other than that, I think his only other moves are his counter and his laser cannon that's attached to his skull. I think around the time that he's at half health, he starts to get faster, and then when he's at about a quarter health, he gets even faster. Now he's a little bit faster. Oh. Come on, Armadillo. Let's do this. You and me, let's dance. A little more. Overall, he's really not that intimidating a boss once you know what you're supposed to do to him. Because otherwise you're just blindly trying to hit him, and he'll just keep shielding himself from your moves. Psychopath.
It was a good fight.
Not really.
Mission accomplished.
Awesome. Now we get Rolling Shield, which only has one real practical use in this entire game. And you'll know it when you see it. But more on that after these commercial messages.